Alrighty, so we're in headphones so I can listen to music. I like listening to music, but if I listen to music in the video gets taken down. So, headphones.
Thank you.
So the cups look good. But if you have a closer look inside, the only place where there's any rust or pitting is right where you don't want any. Eh, how you like them apples? For a break. Alright. Actually, a little more of that action. So, where were we? Got the bearings and the cups cleaned up. We're recording again, so the music's not playing. That's okay. Just got done cleaning up this crank gear. Has a lot of rust on it. Now it has a little rust on it. Probably gonna have to use something a little more aggressive, like maybe a wire wheel. Something like that. To the particularly rusty spots. The important thing really is just this one area here where the bearings roll across it. Gotta get that clean of all the rust. Aluminum foil, some water. Work the left side down like that. See how it works. I don't like these bars. This gooseneck just doesn't seem right for this bike, but good enough. Yeah, this is sort of a BMX style gooseneck. Doesn't really seem to fit the rest of the bike. Whatever. Looks like these gloves are done. My hand looks pretty sweaty too. We're now getting closer. They make a nice tool to press these in. I don't have one of those. Way they go. Are they the same? They appear to be the same. I think they're the same. Sure hope they're the same. Ivy. Yucky, my hands have grease on them, and now I need to clean them,
because
it feels gross. So, since we're done with the grease here, I'm gonna wash my hands.
Oh, no, turn off the camera.
So, pretty sure I put the bearings in upside down in the head. So we're gonna replace those. Turn them around. Their spiders are out tonight. It's actually late at night. It's like 1 in the morning, 2 in the morning, something like that. Because it's the only time that it's cool enough to do anything. It was 111 degrees today, which is a new record, I believe. I don't know. I can't remember any time it's ever been that hot here. So now it's like 80 degrees. And it's just cool enough that I can actually get to work on stuff. And I don't have the right wrench for this, so I should probably make a wrench for this. I got right. Yep. Crazy. Got this one. So, put the bearings in the right way. So I don't know if you can see what I'm talking about, but this gap, there's a gap, big old gap right there, 1/16 of an inch or so. So, appears to be seated pretty good. I want to do.
Alrighty, so I don't know if you can tell, but it's getting daylight.
It's almost 5 in the morning. Alrighty, so the chain.
tweet, tweet.
You hear them birds? I hear them birds. Birds are making that sound again.
The bike. The only thing left is putting on the grips. Not everything, there's still more. Look, wait, there's more. This guy. Oh, there it is. Except, doesn't have the handle grips on it yet. And they did clean up very nice, I gotta say. So, yeah, they did clean up very nice. We'll go back on. But I'm going to... Well, why? Because... I'm going to put some tassels on here. Anyway. There she is. Sterling. Has been refurbished and is back in use. Can be used now. And it looks, doesn't look like a brand new bike or anything. It's pretty much sort of like the way it used to, only less yellowy and a lot shinier. And no rust. Wipe down all the grease. Yeah.